YouTube, what's happening? It's Richard, founder of Short Term Rental University and professional real estate developer. And today I want to share with you a little bit of the lessons that I've learned hosting people on Clubhouse. And if you're not following me on Clubhouse, you should, because I really enjoy the one-on-one dialogue back and forth. You know, when I make these YouTube videos, it's really one to many. And the benefit of Clubhouse is while it's one to many, I can bring individuals on stage and I get to hear your questions in person as opposed to just like comments below in YouTube. I do encourage you to comment below. And while I'm at it, please go ahead and like the video. But here's some interesting things that I heard on Clubhouse as I've started to get on the platform and start to answer people's questions. First off, it was remarkable because I don't know that much about my listeners, my followers, my subscribers. You guys seem to know a lot about me. When I run into people, it's almost like you know me because I've been making these videos for 4 years and traveling the world and so on. But unfortunately, the reverse isn't true. I don't know that much about you. So when I got on Clubhouse and started hosting people and bringing people up, it was really remarkable how grateful people were and how many lives I've changed and how people have advanced and, you know, quit jobs and they were starting in, say, individual short-term rentals and now they're in multifamily and then they're in hotels. And it's just remarkable. And I got to hear these stories firsthand. But one story that I kept hearing repeatedly, and it kind of triggered the point of this video, was about multifamily. So multifamily investors, take note, I'm speaking to you. I can't tell you how many people on the same Clubhouse, I think it was two or three different individuals on the same Clubhouse, I was live for about an hour, told me a very similar story. I have long-term multifamily, a fourplex, a sixplex, a 12plex. And you know, I experimented with short-term rentals. I put my first short-term rental on and it did really well. And then when the next lease came due, I didn't renew it. I went and put that on the short-term rental. And then you fast forward and they were all like, I'm not doing long-term rentals anymore. So let's drill down a little bit. Well, why is that? And I've been saying the same thing. I've been teaching the same thing. I'm not a fan of multifamily rentals in the existing long-term rental market. And the reason is because they are, one, overpriced, which means that they are asymmetrically biased the wrong way. A lot of risk, low reward. The cap rates are really low, meaning the return on your investment is really low. Now, it's safe, it's secure. If all things work out, there's a lot of certainty, and I get all that. You can lever it, you can borrow, there's non-recourse loans. There's a lot of nice things about it, but in terms of return on your investment, it's not necessarily the best place to be in the real estate market. In fact, the best place to be, surprise, surprise, is in the short-term rental market, which is why I started this channel 4 years ago, and I've changed thousands, maybe tens of thousands of lives by introducing the concept of how you can monetize the very roof over your head and you can expand and you can grow and you can do it time and time again. But as it relates to the multifamily investors, they found exactly what it is that I've been teaching, that the returns are so much higher and so much more rewarding in the short-term rental space than the long-term rental. And to prove that to my listeners, I always ask the exact same question. I said, okay, well, walk me through, how much do you get for your long-term rental if somebody signs a 12-month lease? And just for easy math here, they would say $1,000. And I said, oh, okay. And so, you know, if you annualize out with all the uncertainty and the vacancy and the additional cleaning and all the stuff that you have to do, because it is more work to do short-term rentals than multifamily, how much are you making? And consistently in every single example, whether it was a fourplex in San Diego or it was a 12plex in Phoenix, it just doesn't matter where it was in the country. And it almost doesn't even matter the size of the building. Now, we're not talking hundreds of units. These are small entrepreneurs, but in every single case, it was somewhere between 2.5 and 3x. And so what that means is if you're making $1,000 a month on a long-term rental, you could make $2,500 a month on a short-term rental, or $3,000 a month. And your costs, by the way, don't go up, right? Like your mortgage is the same, the utilities are the same, they might even be lower. The wear and tear is the same or lower because there is vacancy. So there's a lot of benefits to it and it's all profit. We charge for our cleaning fees. So that additional expense, and I suggest that you hire a cleaning service, a cleaning lady, don't do it yourself, just pass that through. So when you net $2,500 or $3,000 a month, all that drops to your bottom line. It's all profit, which allows you to grow your real estate empire faster, which allows you to live a more healthy, comfortable lifestyle with more savings. Maybe you want to invest in some Bitcoin. I mean, there's all sorts of things that you can do if you have more income being generated from the same asset. Or you could think of it this way. Let's say that you have a 12 family rented long-term at $1,000 a month. That's $12,000 a month of income. Well, you put it out on the short-term rental market, and let's say you make three times that. Now all of a sudden you're making $36,000 a month. It's almost as if you have three buildings, except you don't have the closing costs, you don't have the financing headache, you don't have the utility bills, you don't have the upkeep, the maintenance, the personnel, the taxes, you don't have any of that. So you just tripled, in essence, your real estate empire without any headache and without any cost. You outsource the cleaning, so like, what's the big deal? So I just wanted to share that with you. I would encourage you to follow me on Clubhouse at I'm Richard Fertig. I'm going to be going live more and more because I really enjoy the dialogue. You know, again, the one-to-many is great. It really gives me scale to get my message out. But the one-on-one personal connection where I get to hear your stories and answer your questions is really cool and very fulfilling for me personally. So I know people that have been following me and participating in it feel similarly, and I really look forward to it. So do me a favor, go ahead and comment below if you're on Clubhouse. Go ahead and below if you want more Clubhouse. Like the video and subscribe to the channel, friends. And remember, the best is yet to come.